The health system in itself has a lot of ailments that need fixing. Funding, and I'm hoping my friend who works in the community health sector there will agree with me, the primary healthcare sector is pretty underfunded in my opinion. If you look at the budgets and spending, I'm going back to the Ottawa Charter where they said there should be an emphasis on research in the health promotion and preventative area, and in the 2005-06 budget of the public health spending cycle, it was 3.7% spent. So you can see the small amount of budgeting that we actually get. Try to be a bit environmental, but I'm not always the best, but I've become really aware of the environment because there's a huge link with health and the environment. The fact that Ballarat has an people that are underemployed and unemployment, and we were something like 8.3% and the state average is 5%, so we're highly represented in that area. So my vision for Ballarat is that there would be an opportunity for all to contribute, whatever level that may be. In 2020 they're saying that 25% of Ballarat's residents will be over 60, so we are an ageing population, and I'm heading that way myself, so it's not that far heading in that direction, but you know, we have a lot, and I suppose Cliff also may have this experience, but we have a lot of people that have a heck of a lot to contribute to the health and well-being of other people in the community. So we have volunteers who do a wonderful job in terms of courier servicing for our agency or coming in and assisting with programs. Some of the other visions I'd like to see is more obviously employment opportunities. We know that financially where there's disadvantage, that leads to social disadvantage, leads to increases in things like smoking rates, alcohol rates, obesity, and through that program you'll see there's a whole lot of issues that address that. And a lot of young people I work with fall through the gaps, and so do a lot of people in the community. So this is a safety net, and sometimes in my experience the system lets us down. And I'm talking there when I'm working with young people, big systems like Department of Health, Child Protection, it can let people down, and that's our safety net. And so for me, there's lots of gaps in our social system, and to me this is people like myself in the community health sector who run programs on a shoestring budget. If we can actually pull together and work across the sectors such as education and other agencies, we might actually be able to capture some of those people so that they don't fall through the net. So what I'm saying is we're a very consumable society where we want things fast and quickly. So I've sort of joked with a colleague, our carriageway into our community health centre, we should have, and often I have people that might have an appointment with us, and if you've ever waited in a waiting room, all things happen in a waiting room, they might have a 10 o'clock appointment and they'll front and say, I've got to be somewhere in 10 minutes. So, you know, you're trying, you know, to juggle all that. So I said we should have like a fast line for quick fixes for health, fast line for fast information for health, and for the young people I work with who want it fixed yesterday, have another tube to go there. As a PAP nurse test provider, you know, a negative result's a good thing. And then again, if I'm working with someone in the sexual health area, positive's a bad thing. And then sometimes if you're planning a pregnancy, a positive's a great thing. And then sometimes, for me, if you're not wanting, you know, you can have negatives and positives that give mixed health messages to people that I work with. So our terminology, absolutely, in my opinion, just disenfranchise people to start with. If we could have more funding it's a bit like climate change, it's no use doing the preventative work, and if you're going to wait till an emergency happens, and that's what I find with health, if you don't put the preventative dollars in, then you're going to have emergencies in terms of your chronic disease, in terms of your cancers, in terms of your ill health. So if you don't put the dollars in at the start, then you're not going to get the outcome that you hope for. But the big lead in there was about the fantastic job that parents are doing, school-based programs are doing, and that most of the students, 88%, felt confident to go and seek help. There's great messages. My vision for health is that, you know, we allow opportunities for all cultures, people, whatever that means in their contribution to help towards their mental health. I think there needs to be more funding in the community sector right across the board. And I think that I'm really positive about the future with the young people we have, that we say young people are our future. I think our future is with our young people, and as an ageing population we're going to need them to come forward and look after us as we age.